So we're at the player haters ball here.
Yeah, we are.
We might as well keep with another player that everyone hates. No respect at all for this guy. Who just continuous hatred. Lamar Miller at 93. And again, we talked about kind of P. Ryan probably continuing to slide if they draft somebody. I think 93 is conservative right now for Lamar Miller. I think this number is going to continue to go down.
Sure.
Especially as the Deontay Foreman love ramps up once he starts to get healthy.
Well, Foreman's at 98. Lamar Miller's at 93. There's no way they don't switch places.
Right.
They're definitely switching places.
And I think they're going in opposite directions for, you know, I can get behind Foreman. I like Foreman coming out, and he did flash some in this offense last year. But let's get into Lamar Miller at 93 here. Even though with all that said, let's talk about him at 93.
Well, as bad as it felt last year for number 93 ADP here in Lamar Miller, I saw a stat the other day. He was in the tops of the league in face and loaded boxes because
at like 47%.
Yeah, at half the time he's running against more defenders than they can block. And he also was, 12 or 13th in total yards produced.
Right.
So it's bad. Like, he just didn't score any touchdowns.
And to say like, with the loaded boxes, it's with plus one.
One more defender than they can block.
Right.
Right. So, let's be honest here. When Deshaun Watson was in there, Lamar Miller was a different running back. Deshaun Watson didn't play very long, unfortunately, because of the knee injury. But the Houston Texans offense within a calendar year has transformed itself.
Absolutely.
They were making the playoffs for a couple years in a row on the backs of JJ Watt and some great defense.
And an atrocious offense.
Oh, horrible offense. Pick six offense. They were throwing it to the other team more than they were throwing it to themselves. You bring in Will Fuller. You bring in Lamar Miller hasn't been gangbusters, but he's been a solid running back and very underappreciated. And you absolutely strike it rich. You trade it up for Deshaun Watson, which I loved about the Texans just to begin with, because they traded up and took the right guy. And they just turned their whole offense around basically with a quarterback. That's how it works.
Mm.
But, I mean, you got Lamar. If Deshaun Watson's on the field for the rest of the season last year, Lamar Miller is not being talked about like this.
Maybe he is. It just seems like perpetual hate regardless of what's going on with Lamar Miller.
Well,
as bad as it was, still RB16 overall. And, like, the total yardage, I thought I had it somewhere, but, like, his total yardage number was up there in the 12 or 13.
It was the total yardage number was higher than the fantasy ranking number because of the touchdowns. It wasn't there for him. But where were the touchdowns at all when Deshaun Watson wasn't playing?
Right.
Nobody was getting touchdowns.
And I don't disagree that Foreman may possibly be the future, but like you said, this offense has turned around, and I want every piece that I can get of this offense. And, you know, I just think there's a ton of disrespect for Miller. I think he'll still produce. Now, there is a possibility that they say that Lamar Miller, they could cut him to save $5 million or whatever, which to me, if we want to start talking about this and all the speculation, like, you got a guy who's a rookie coming off an Achilles injury.
Foreman coming back with a busted up ankle.
You're not a cap-strapped team.
Right.
You got a guy who's been, you know, he hasn't been this superstar that you wanted him to be, but damn it, you haven't really helped him at all. And when Deshaun was out there, he was just fine. He was great. Borderline great.
Right.
I loved everything I saw with Lamar Miller when, like, you know, you had a crappy offensive line. Why would you cut Lamar
Doesn't
Miller
make any
just
sense.
To save? If you want to
Zero
cut him,
sense.
Maybe you're going to draft another running back or pick up another running back. But you got a rookie coming off of an Achilles injury, which can drastically hurt your explosion and all that kind of stuff. Like, I just not sure why you would go ahead and just cut Lamar. Like, you have a legitimate shot. J.J. Watt comes back.
Yeah.
Clowney comes back. You have decent defensive backs. You have Merciless. Like, you get a another okay offensive lineman mixed in there, and maybe a better serviceable tight end. And you have a team that's not a great division. Obviously, Jacksonville just, you know,
came out of nowhere.
But this is a playoff team.
No doubt.
Like, why would you For what? For $5
million?
Well,
he's got a bad yards per carry.
Right.
It's 3.7.
But if I would understand it, if you make a strong move for a highly touted back, not named
Sajay. You just drafted one.
I know. Well, I know. Like you said, you got Foreman, who's a youngster in May, and did look good in spurts and shots, and he looked good catching a couple of balls out of the backfield and taking it down the sideline. I'm not going to say he didn't look good, but like you said, he's coming back from a ruptured Achilles. Like, it ain't been long since, but nobody, Terrell Suggs, you don't do that.
He sizzled. He made it look easy.
If your name ain't Suggs and you ain't the toughest man on the field, you don't play football after you tear your Achilles. And so this is, and you have a young, you have the brightest, you have the best thing, you have the best thing to ever happen to your franchise.
Deshaun
Watson. I mean, J.J. Watt, he's the man of the year, and he does, you know, he's great for the franchise, don't get me wrong, but you have the quarterback, which is what matters in football. You have Deshaun Watson coming back off a busted knee. You got your potential future running back coming off of a blown out Achilles. Why not hang on to Lamar Miller and just be able to use a quality running back?
Use a guy who's familiar with what's going on. He's been around the organization.
If you get a second round running back, maybe named Darius Geis or one of those, maybe if you bring in Nick Chubb or Sony Michel, I get it. But one of the, not name those guys.
Why would you do that? You have other problems.
Other problems. Right. Other problems.
And this dude, Lamar Miller, is basically the model of consistency. Looking at his game log, it's very solid to quite solid, like you said, when Deshaun Watson was in there. He's only missed two games in the last 5 years of his career playing the running back position. That's very impressive. He did leave a bit of a bad taste in owners' mouths. The last four games of the year weren't the greatest statistically, but he was playing through a knee injury, and the team was already out of the playoffs.
The team was done.
Right, so why they risk him? And there's like blurbs of how Alfred Blue outplayed him from a number standpoint, and then like they literally on Christmas there was a blurb that said, quote, Lamar Miller outplayed by Blue versus Steelers, end quote, and then goes on to say and explain that he rushed 10 times for 55 yards, which if my math's right, that's 5.5 yards per carry. That means he's good. So I don't know what this whole hate thing is about that. And then you got to go down to the game logs to see that he also added a catch for 10 yards. They didn't mention his one catch, his one target for 10 yards, which he had no drops on the season. So no drops charted with for Lamar Miller. Thought that was very impressive. He had 36 receptions, which is pretty solid. It's very, very. That's what brings his floor up. Like, there's not very many games aside from the end of the season when he was playing through a knee injury that he didn't get you double-digit points.
Right. And now if you can have a bit more of an efficient offense, there's not too many offenses that are running with bell cow backs. There's plenty of offenses that are splitting with two guys. We've seen Lamar flourish with a little bit less.
Right.
Less might be a little bit more with him, and he's been very consistent. And you give him maybe 5-6 touchdowns on the year, and all of a sudden, everyone's, you know, Lamar Miller's saving your franchise.
He had six. So running, I'm in with catching. That.
Yeah.
He's a fast dude. He's got 4.4 speed, and he can bust off big plays, but it's strange because he didn't have his longest run was 21 yards, and his longest reception was 36 yards. Like, those numbers,
it's hard to bust off long
strange.
Runs when everybody in the box is just trying to shut you down.
And when your whole offensive line is full of red players on Pro Football Focus,
just
like
a bunch
those
of garbage.
Are all bad scores.
Deshaun Watson turns the offensive line into...
And when he comes in, it's like, was there a major upgrade on the offensive line?
Absolutely
or is maybe
not.
Just Deshaun Watson has the ability to make everyone around him play better. That's one of my most favorite features about him is that he brings everybody else's quality
of
play
up. I
think
you said it at one point. He's like your sixth offensive lineman when you put him in there.
You can't sack him on that first guy.
He's super mobile. He's not looking to run, and he can stay in the pocket and create downfield.
Jay Wayne, to say that one more time, how many red dots on Pro Football Focus
all
did they
them.
Have for the offensive line?
All five.
Five?
Yeah.
Five red dots.
Five
red's not
red.
Good.
Red's
not, bad?
Red's below
five,
average.
Five,
quite
five bad offensive linemen.
Right.
That ain't good.
Yeah.
And no, not a good blocking tight
solid
end anywhere.
Solid blocking scheme, though. They do run the ball well.
So
Bill O'Brien is a guy who wants to run the ball.
Right.
So having two guys who can do it is just fine. And there isn't any stats that say Donta Foreman was doing that against loaded boxes. Like, when Donta Foreman was getting his opportunities, everyone was like, good, Lamar's out of the game. Let's back up and defend these receivers.
There's nothing wrong with the Texans maybe drafting 3 or 4 offensive linemen.
Right.
You know? Like, you got to get rid of those red dots, bro. You can't be having five of them.
And they had some injuries. Who's the guy that was holding out to through most of the year?
They shipped him over.
Oh, yeah, it was one of
Seattle.
The best left tackles in the game.
Yeah, Dwayne Brown.
Why don't you pay him?
Yeah.
They are stubborn, is what happened there. If you got five red dots that they're not quite as red if you got one anchor left tackle, and you got Dwayne Brown. But you know what you did? You let him go to somebody in NFC.
Yep.
What are you doing?
Not that PFF is in the colors on PFF or the NLB all, but like, it's just worth noting that this dude didn't have a good offensive line. That was evident to see if you watched Tom Savage play.
And
Deshaun comes in there, and he's just scrambling and keeping plays alive just amazingly. You just see everything that you saw out of him in college.
And then you get, you got people on there like, oh, well, he old Foreman drastically outplayed Lamar Miller. Like, what you saw was is Watson scramble around and hit Foreman on a play where nobody was around him, and then he ran down the field and made somebody miss. Like, I'm not taking any. I like Foreman.
And he's got
to hate on Foreman at all. I like Foreman. I think these guys should coexist and be a really good tandem in the backfield.
Absolutely.
I'm just saying, I don't see the hatred for Lamar Miller. Like, everyone hates this guy and says he sucks so much. I just don't think it's a fact.
Yeah, look, Dante Foreman caught three balls, and one of them just happened to be down the sideline on. And Deshaun Watson made that play.
Oh yeah,
he made somebody miss, and he ran for a long time down the sideline, and it looked good, no doubt about
it.
He
made like two people miss.
And Dante Foreman can create on his own. Like, I mean, I'm again, I don't not. This isn't the purpose to like. I don't like. Right. I like Foreman.
We're not hating on Foreman.